The Longjiang Gymnasium welcomes you along to judo from the second Summer Youth Olympic Games, Nanjing in China. And we've got some medals on offer tonight that will no doubt provide excellent entertainment. It is so spectacular, this tournament. It has been the opening 2 days, and we enter the evening session on day three, the medal day. We'll see medals decided in the women's under 78 kilograms and the men's 100 kilogram contests. It will be outstanding. Judo derived from jiu-jitsu, the hand-to-hand combat technique of ancient samurai warriors. It involves throwing opponents to the floor and holding them in submission. Relatively new sport in China. It was introduced from Japan in the 1970s, in fact. And plenty of eyes on that yellow mat, including the Venezuelans. They're in action tonight, a chance for a bronze medal, and they're out in force, providing plenty of colour and movement. You can't miss a thing here. Don't know that you need the binoculars. Everything's up close. It is fast, it is furious, and it has been a pleasure to be part of. Big crowds enjoying the action. And the first of the medal moments not too far away. The athletes here that have already competed and will again on day four are here watching, of course. And Nanjing really turning it on for the Youth Olympic Games. The southern capital of China. We'll see the big boys, the men in the 100 kilogram division a little bit later on. If you open proceedings, it will be the women's under 78 kg on that mat. And the first bout will be the first of the bronze medal bouts. Spain and South Africa in action, then the Venezuelans. Venezuela and France. And it's Bosnia and Herzegovina and Croatia that will do battle for the gold.
Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, now it's time for the third bronze medal back for women on the 78 kilo.
Ladies and gentlemen, we will take the first place.
Please welcome the judges and referees.
We're ready to go, and here they come. In wide, Sarah Rodriguez of Spain. Behind her in the blue, Unel Sneeman from South Africa. First of the two bronze medals on offer this evening in the women's under 78 kilogram division. Too keen to get going is Rodriguez. Sneeman. Unel Sneeman, the tallest of the competitors in the under 78 kilogram division at 184 centimeters over 6 foot, so she's got some extra reach. Doesn't mean anything early as these girls try to get a positive grip. Start proceedings with some momentum. Very tactical sport. It looks brutal, and an early attempt Asianagi from Rodriguez there, unable to throw her opponent over her shoulders. That's what they're looking for, the instant victory, throwing your opponent onto their back, onto the mat. Receiving the Ippon victory, it can happen quickly. It goes the distance, it's a 4 minute bout. And again, the drop attempt from Rodriguez. Referee says no score and awards a penalty against Sneeman. Her defensive response to that attack from Rodriguez. It cannot be ultra defensive here. You're too passive, as has occurred, you are penalised. The South African's brother, Ruben Tobi, recently won a silver medal in the Commonwealth Games. So the family's in form. And no score again from that, as spectacular as it looked, and continue is the call. And now Sneeman, also a member of the South African national netball team, so a very talented athlete, just 18 years of age. Rodriguez also 18, turned 18 in January. Rafa Nadal is her hero. And I'm sure somewhere, some part of the globe, Rafa's watching. Hoping the Spaniard can do what he so often does. Lots of support from the stands for both these girls. Now we're about to enter the second half of the 4 minutes. Just the two Shido penalties against the South African. Rodriguez with the advantage, but one score will usurp that. Spain in white, South Africa in blue. And not wanting to give anything up on the counter-attack. These girls are very careful not to overcommit. Footwork is the key. Have to maneuver your opponent. Try to just throw their balance, and the drop Sinagi attempt once again from Rodriguez, unable to flip her opponent over her shoulder, so immediately tries the stranglehold, but nothing doing. Back into the middle of the mat we come. A bronze medal to the victor. And going to ground there, Rodriguez. Sneeman tries to take advantage. Can't do so. That extra reach. 184 centimetres versus 171. The extra reach not providing a great advantage up high. Same time, Rodriguez would be keen to get down to the mat. Once again, she's trying plenty of moves, and in that defensive manoeuvre from Sneeman, Rodriguez quick to try to put the choke hold on. Maybe an arm lock. As you can see, expending a lot of energy, so powerful. With less than a minute to go. It's the South African now reaping her leg across her opponent. Looking for the hip movement, core body strength. Just imperative. Now reaching over the top, the South African to try to get a grip. Does that. Has to get up. Now how did Rodriguez defend that? She was quick to go to ground. I wonder whether the referee will make a call. No, play on. So with those two penalties, it's the Spaniard in front. Rodriguez unable to get a score on the board. And once again, I think the referee will come in. And yes, this time he does award a penalty against Rodriguez for going to ground too easily. So she still holds the advantage on the Shido penalties. Just 10 seconds to go. There's the Sinagi. How was the throw? No score by the looks of things. But crucially for Rodriguez, seconds taken off the clock. Something would have to go horribly wrong now as we tick towards the bell. There it is. And Sarah Rodriguez is the bronze medalist. She earned that, these two working so hard. And look at the sportsmanship there. Tremendous from the South African. Unel Sneeman over to lift her opponent from the mat. To the applause of her countrymen and women, her coaches and compatriots in the stands. A battle to the very, very end to decide a bronze medal in the under 78 kg women's judo Nanjing 2014. Sneeman there, exhausted. Had absolutely everything she had, just one Shido penalty, the difference. Neither judoka able to get a score on the board. And with no energy left, Rodriguez can only barely get herself and the judogi back together. She does now. Oh, that's fantastic. The victor raises the arm of the vanquished as well. Well done, Sarah Rodriguez. Winner by Shido and Youth Olympic bronze medalist. And a wave to the folks at home. Rafa, if you're watching, the Spanish flag will be flying. It was tough as it has been all week here at the Longjiang Gymnasium. And that was that late throw that almost got a score for Rodriguez, but the damage had already been done in terms of penalties. Just had one Rodriguez bronze medal. Will we have another? In white, now from Venezuela. And you'll know all about the support that Alvismar Rodriguez receives in just a moment. And in blue from France, Morgan Duchenne. Bronze medal up for the taking, women's under 78 kilograms. Venezuela in white, France in blue. Strong from both of these girls. Rodriguez, 17 years of age, just 168 kilograms. Her natural weight is well below the maximum 78 kilogram division that she's fighting in, and Duchenne, 18 in May, 180 centimeters, so she has a good reach and should have a weight pull as well. But it's the lady in white from Caracas that is keen to get her opponent to the floor in the early stages, just can't do so. Rodriguez defeating Poland by Ippon twice, unusual to have to beat the same athlete twice to stay alive, having lost to Croatia by Yoko to reach this part of the tournament. And Duchenne defeated Australia in golden score, Shido, and then lost to Bosnia Herzegovina and Ippon. And that's why these two meet here for bronze. The winner walks away with a great experience. The winner, the bronze medal on top. And difficult for either of these girls to get an advantage in the early game. Duchenne getting those long limbs out there. Rodriguez going down and now finds herself on the back, but Duchenne unable to put any sort of strong hold on. You have to be so explosive to be good at this sport at these young ages. these girls an example of the wonderful talent that exists in the world. And the takedown there from Rodriguez. Looks like there's a Wazari score. The referee liked it. Should the judges do? No score. No score. These medal matches, nothing is given away, that's for sure. They're trying to hook the right leg around and throw her French opponent, is Rodriguez. Starting to feel the strain of a long day at the office. We're going to Chen. There the Venezuelans. They made plenty of noise as Rodriguez made her way into this bronze medal bout earlier in the day. And Duchen taking herself down, pulling her opponent with her. And there is a point there, and it is going to the French girl. Again, Duchen with the minor Yuko. Into the second half of this bout. It's a nice advantage, and now going on the attack, Duchen. I think she'll get a hold there. Going around the waist, and Mate is called by the referee, and the ladies come back into the middle. Gold medalist in the South American Championships at under 18 level, Elismar Rodriguez, last year. She's more than capable. Not everyone that confident. Once again, Duchen looking to throw her body weight, and Rodriguez turns defense into attack there nicely, puts a hold on, and we have a count here. This is a good hold Rodriguez has. You can see that count in the background. If it gets to 10, we have a score. It has now Wazari, and we're not far away from Ippon. This may be all over right here, right now. It is. What a wonderful hold. Great strength. And the Venezuelans are on their feet. So is Elvisma Rodriguez. She is a Youth Olympic bronze medalist. And looks like she could do it all again. Morgan Duchen really feeling the effects of that. Was first to score with the Yuko. But then that strong hold was able to hang on for the 15 seconds necessary. And here's the dance. I have a feeling Elvisma, who can't see that, well, she can. She's looking at the monitor. The fan club is behind her. She might turn around and get involved. Bronze medal to Venezuela. Just a little fist pump. Now she can let the hair down, so to speak, if she chooses. Morgan Duchen caught it right out. The bronze medal to this lady, 17-year-old from Caracas. Really produced when she had to at the very end there. Okay, this is it. This is the gold medal contest for the women's under 78 kilogram division. It's Bosnia Herzegovina and Croatia. Aleksandra Samardic in the white, Brigita Matic in the blue. The two favorites going into the tournament, and here they are on the mat. One wins gold, the other takes silver. Going to grip up there. The extra reach, the 6 foot tall, 182 centimeter. Matic in the blue. Also, at this stage of their careers, the more natural 78 kilogram fighter. Matic is 18 in January. Samardic just 16 years of age. And naturally weighs in at about 70 kilograms. So might have enjoyed some pizza just to boost the strength late. And she's got plenty of it. And she discards Brigitte Matic there. No score. The 16-year-old in white has already competed at senior level with success. Two gold medals in the Euro Cup in the under 70 in the senior age group in Belgrade and Sarajevo, her hometown in fact, in March, that victory. And also a couple of under 21 Euro Cup golds in July. So in super form, the young lady in white, Brigitte Matic though, also at senior level, a solid performer, a bronze medalist on the Grand Prix Tour, and also a Euro Cup bronze medal in Sarajevo in the under 78 kg division. So an unusual matchup in some ways, but two names that we'll be hearing a lot of in this sport in the future. Aleksandra Samardic and Brigitte Matic. Bosnia Herzegovina in white, Croatia in the blue. One shido penalty against both ladies. Could be the natural way in a final. You don't want to overcommit and leave yourself vulnerable. If you're not on the attack almost all the time, you have to keep yourself busy in this sport. The referee quick to offer a penalty. Four penalties, four of those yellow marks alongside your name, and you are disqualified. That won't happen here though, as we're in the second half of this bout and the girls really lift. Matic trying to get a hold here. Good defensive pose from Samardic. And come back to the middle of the mat, although there is a penalty given, a second penalty awarded. It's not on the board, but yes it is. It has gone to Samardic for that defensive pose. Too quick to move into there, so by way of penalties, Croatia with the slight advantage. That's enough to decide the medal, so it means Aleksandra has to get busy. Busier than she's already been. A little pocket rocket, 16 years of age. The Youth Olympic Games open to athletes from 14 to 18. Chance for the senior stars of the future to shine early, and attempting the drop Shianagi there was Samardic, just unable to complete the throw, and that allows Matic in. She tries to get a hold of her opponent here, maybe put some sort of submission hold on, or maybe the arm lock. Can she get hold of the arm? No. Tucked up in defense. Brigitte Matic says she likes to play cards. Well, by way of the penalties, she has the upper hand at the moment. An ace in the pack needed from Samardic with less than 20 seconds to go, or the gold will go to Croatia. She continues to work. She has hold of the arm, takes her opponent to ground, and able to get out of that. Matic, that was a big move, and now she's on top. She tries to get the hold. She's just happy for the clock to count down. She can see it, and now she can celebrate. A gold medal to Croatia. Finally, the smile arrives on the face. The arm raises in the air. The Croatians in the crowd lift the flag, and we'll wait for it to become official in just a moment. As is her nickname, Giga Matic of Croatia. Is the victor. And it's official. She is a gold medalist. The two athletes come together on the middle of the mat. A very tough bout, decided by shido penalties alone. 16-year-old Aleksandra Samardic, a wonderful performance from someone so young, giving up age and weight and height to her opponent. But take nothing away, Brigitte Matic. She's a star. And she is a Youth Olympic gold medalist from Nanjing 2014. That's how it happened. Let's have a look. Once again, these wonderful pictures coming from the Longjiang gymnasium of these two. Just working so hard, going the distance. And there is the victory.
Now the men's 100 kilogram division bronze medal contest, there will only be one bronze medal decided in competition here at Nanjing 2014 in the men's over 81 and under 100 kilogram division, because there were only four entries. This bronze medal contest brings together Dominik Schönfeld of Germany in white and Gustavo Bisele of Argentina in the blue. A 4-minute contest for a bronze medal. And immediately, it's Schönfeld on the attack, but both will be a match for each other here, you would expect. Bisele disqualified in his semi-final after he, on the ground, made use of his opponent's leg. And on the other hand, Schönfeld was narrowly defeated in golden score on Shido. So he had a much longer battle, but it was just the one match because of the small field. They went straight to the semi-final, just four entries in this division. But now a bronze medal on offer and a battle of legwork. The German with his left foot forward, hip throw attempted by Bisele in the blue. Schönfeld of Germany in the white turns his man over, turns Bisele and goes for the hold. Bisele trying to keep the arm away from the upper body and towards the edge of the contest area. These two of fairly even stature when it comes to size, height, weight. And it is Schönfeld who, oh, he turns his opponent back, changes direction and scores with a Yuko. Schönfeld, Yuko. Good change of direction there from the German. Was throwing in one direction and then reversed the force. Gustavo Bisele goes for the grip, and both of them gripping up. And now the legwork, and it is the German, Schönfeld, going for the arm lock and striving to get it. Bisele fights back. The leg is in place, he's trying to break the grip. You can see that Bisele has both hands locked. If the German can break that lock, he'll be able to apply the lock. And the referee is keeping a very close eye on it, but Bisele able to repel that challenge. A lot of power involved though from Dominik Schönfeld in the white for Germany. Schönfeld, 18 years old, 91 kilograms. Bisele is a few kilograms heavier, in fact. Also 18 years old. Bisele moving into the hip throw position, but quickly going back on it, realizing the danger. It wasn't in position. He couldn't buckle his man's balance. Now leg work from both. Out of the contest area. Bisele came second at the Pan American Championship Cadets in 2013. Schönfeld fifth in the World Championships in his division. Working with the legs. both with a firm grip and the attempted throw from Basile as he dropped down, but couldn't execute, couldn't maintain his grip. Schoenfeld, very good in defence, and with a one Yuko lead, that's all he has to do at this stage, and the Argentinian knows it. He's trying to initiate the attack. The referee says that was a drop-down false attack, and a yellow Shido card penalty goes against him. So he's in trouble here. Oh no, it's been overruled. The officials deciding that was a fair attack. But nevertheless, still the German leads with a score of Yuko. A score of Yuko on the board in favour of Dominik Schoenfeld. The bronze medal is only 13 seconds away if he can maintain this lead. Oh, and a big throw! It's Ippon! It doesn't need Yuko, it's Ippon! Dominik Schoenfeld counter-attacking in most spectacular style. One of the most magnificent throws of the day, and emphatically he seizes the bronze medal. What a way to finish, and what a way to mark your name down in Youth Olympic Games history. The second summer Youth Olympic Games, Nanjing 2014, and the name of Dominik Schoenfeld goes into the medal tally. Game effort from Gustavo Basile, but the glory of a bronze medal goes to that man, Dominik Schoenfeld, from Hanover in Germany. Schoenfeld, winner by Ippon in magnificent style, takes the bronze medal for Germany. And there it is, in convincing fashion, lifting his man, and onto his back goes Basile for Ippon. Now the gold medal contest. The men's under 100 kilogram division, the bronze medal match. Both guaranteed of either gold or silver, but it's gold that glitters brightest. In the white, Ramin Safavieh from Iran. And in blue, Radoslav Dashkov of Kyrgyzstan. Safavieh is 18 years old. Dashkov in the blue, just 16. He'll be 17 in October. But right now, he's just 16, so considerably younger than his opponent. Safavieh wanting to follow in the footsteps of his hero, fellow Iranian judoka Ares Mereshmali. Shido penalties issued against both. The referee wants to see some good gripping here. He doesn't want to see the grip being battered away. He also wants to see both men genuine in their attacking intent. Dashkov, a fainting leg, leading out. Again, not any strength in his leg work at the moment. Half-heartedly trying to whip at the legs of the Iranian. 4-minute bout here for the gold medal. Safavieh weighing in at 100 kilograms, and Dashkov lighter, 10 kilograms lighter at 90. You can see the height of Safavieh. Not that there's a great deal in it, but Safavieh is the tallest man of the four who have taken part in this weight division. The heaviest of the men's youth Olympic Games competition, the under 100 kilograms, over 81 kilogram division. Both now have Shido penalties against each other as we hit the 2 minute mark. Looking for a grip to establish their position, the foundation for the throw. Over the top goes the Iranian, Safavieh, reaching over the top to the back of the shoulder. The referee just cautions the coaches to make sure their conduct is appropriate. 1 minute 30 remaining in this gold medal match. And the referee not happy with the Kyrgyzstan coach. And he is told that he will have to leave the side of the arena. Has to leave the side of the mat. So Radoslav Dashkov of Kyrgyzstan now on his own. His coach has left. He'll do it on his own if he can do it. He's got a tough opponent in Rahman Safavieh as he goes on the attack now, the man in white, and he lifts his opponent up and rolls him over. He goes for the hold, picks him up and turns him, goes for the hold. And we have a score, I believe. The clock is on Osakomi, coming up to the 10-second mark. Yuko for the hold. I don't know whether Dashkov can escape here as it's up, coming up towards Ippon. 19, 20 seconds, Ippon, and a gold medal to Rahman Safavieh of Iran. Injured himself in winning the gold medal, but I'm sure the glory of the gold will take away some of the pain. Radoslav Dashkov of Kyrgyzstan takes the silver medal, but defeated by a limping Rahman Safavieh. In applying the hold, he's caused himself some pain, and now he collapses on the mat to the side of the contest area, but he has the gold medal. Rahman Safavieh of Iran is the winner of the gold, winner by Ippon. It should be a most wonderful moment for him, but instead, obviously, he is in serious pain from a leg injury, a high leg injury. His coach is coming around now to see how serious it is. An unfortunate way to end the gold medal contest, with the winner unable to celebrate his moment. This shows the intensity with which he conducted the fight. He put the hold in place, but in doing so has been injured, yet continued to maintain the pressure. Up until that point, it was very even on penalties. Two penalties apiece had been issued. And he reached down, lifted his opponent up, turned him over, and then applied the hold. Celebrations for his coach and all of his supporters in Iran. It is a step towards emulating his hero, Arash Mirishmali.